everyone. Greetings in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I want to thank God for giving me this opportunity to share this Lent devotion based on the theme Enlightening Faith. The scripture portion taken for reference today is Luke chapter 18 verses 35 to 43. This is a passage where we see Jesus giving sight to a blind beggar. We are all blessed with five senses, and when one of the sense organs is lost, the whole body goes into disarray. In this passage, we see a desperate blind beggar's plea to restore his sight. When I read this passage, I see three main characters. First, the blind beggar. Mark tells us that his name was Bartimaeus. We do not know how long he has been blind. He has been sitting by the roadside because that's where he could meet most people. He could not see anything around him, and whatever he knew, he was what someone described to him. When he heard the crowd going, he asked what was going on. And when he knew it was Jesus, he cried out, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." Even when others rebuked him and told him to be quiet, that did not stop him. He cried out louder. How did he know Jesus? He had never met him. How did he know that he was the Son of David? A blind man could see what men with sight could not. That brings us to the second character, the person who described Jesus to the blind man. This man took the time to paint a beautiful picture in the canvas of the blind's mind of Jesus, so much so that the blind realized that it was only through Jesus he could see the light. He gave him hope when he was living in the tunnel of darkness. He described the Son of Man so vividly that the blind man believed in Jesus' ability to heal. Believing his narrator fully, the blind cried out louder for Jesus to have mercy on him. The belief of the blind man started with that person. Let's ask ourselves, have we taken time to describe Christ to others? Are we willing to be the light bearers to show people who live in darkness the light of the world? The third character here is Jesus himself. I don't think Jesus did not know that the beggar needed healing. I also don't think that he did not hear him with his first cry. Jesus knew what he needed even before he asked him. But then he wanted to see if he had enough faith to be persistent. When he stopped and asked for the beggar to be brought to him, he asked, "What do you want me to do for you?" The man replied, "I want to see." The blind belief of the blind man towards him made Jesus act and give him sight, saying, "Your faith has healed you." In John chapter 8, verses 12, Jesus states, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have light." He invites you to enter in his light. When we are blinded by the darkness of this world, the darkness of sin, Jesus invites us into his light. We need to realize our need of deliverance and in faith cry out to help us see the light. The cry for mercy and the faith that the blind man exhibited should be a constant prayer and guidance. Darkness cannot drive out darkness, only light can do that. Our darkened reality needs something from outside itself. It comes in the person of Jesus. "I am the light," he says. As the sun is necessary to the solar system, so is Christ to this dark, sin-filled world. In Matthew chapter 5, verses 14 through 16, he also gives us the responsibility of being his torchbearers. He states, "You're the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand. And it gives light to all the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven." Here we see Jesus calling us to live a life of active faith, not a passive one. Put your light on its stand. Your circumstances are an opportunity to shine brightly for the Lord and to share God's overcoming truth with those around you. Your family and community can tell what you believe by how you live. Like the person who introduced the blind to Jesus, let us be his witnesses, shining his guiding light to others who are in the dark. "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." What a beautiful prayer, which we can so easily make our own today and every day. We need to stand in the presence of Jesus and ask him persistently to have mercy on us in all our needs and frailties. We might also hear Jesus asking us, "What do you want me to do for you?" We need to be prompt as the blind man to answer. For that, we need to know as well as he did what we truly desire from Jesus. We too can ask to see again, to see God's enlightening presence in our lives, and to live and walk in his light. To remain in his light, we need to do two things. First, we need to grow in our knowledge of God. We need to grow in knowledge of His beauty, His love, holiness, and goodness. Second, we need to learn and grow in the knowledge of our own sinfulness. The more His light shines on our darkened hearts, the more we see. During this Lent season, let us examine ourselves. Are we blinded by our own sinfulness? Have we realized our truest needs and sought out Christ persistently like the blind man? Does our life reflect His light to others? Today, let us invite Christ, the light that dispels all darkness, into our lives. May God bless you and enlighten you during this Lent season.